In this video, I am going to discuss about activity-based costing. ABC is the acronym for activity-based costing. Marginal and absorption costing techniques are traditional methods, whereas activity-based costing is more suitable for modern business environments. We discussed about the marginal costing and the absorption costing. Now you have the full understanding about these costing techniques. These are traditional methods. But activity-based costing method is a modern method. This is because overheads have a higher portion than direct costs in the production cost per unit. One of the main reasons for that is, instead of direct labor, machines and automation are commonly used in the production process. This is why the modern business environment is different from the traditional business environments. Instead of direct labor, now the machines and automation are commonly used for the production processes. When the overheads are significant, there should be a more accurate method to identify the overheads per unit other than using the absorption costing technique. The better solution is ABC. As now you know, we use the absorption costing technique to absorb the overheads to the production cost per unit. But in the modern business environment, this technique is not accurate and useful. So we have to use the activity-based costing. Activity-based costing is similar to absorption costing, but more advanced. You can say activity-based costing is a type of absorption costing, but it is more advanced than the traditional absorption costing. So when can the management accountants use the activity-based costing technique? When direct costs are less than overheads, which means overheads are significant. More machine-intensive production processes than using direct labor. This means less direct labor is used in the production processes. When consumption of overheads are not primarily driven by the production units. If you can remember, under absorption costing, we use the number of production units as the primary base value or the activity level. When the activity level is not primarily driven by the production units, we can use the activity-based costing. Different number of products consuming different amounts of resources, which means there are more than one product in the company. So these products are consuming different amounts of the same resources. When smaller batch sizes are produced at a time, more accurate costing is needed to set the prices. These are the instances where the ABC will be more useful. Now let's discuss about the difference between absorption costing and activity-based costing. As now you know, ABC is an advanced absorption costing technique. In absorption costing, production overheads were allocated and apportioned to cost centers and then absorbed into the production cost per unit by using an OAR. OAR is the overhead absorption rate. The activity level used to calculate the OAR was arbitrary and not suitable to use in the modern business environment. In ABC, production overheads will be identified separately as activities, and then a cost driver will be identified for each activity. Using this cost driver, an OAR will be calculated in order to reliably measure the production cost per unit. Under ABC, this OAR will be known as the driver rate. The main difference between the absorption costing and the ABC is that under absorption costing, we recognize the costs under cost centers. Whereas in activity-based costing, we recognize the overheads as activities. Instead of using an arbitrary activity level, we use a cost driver under activity-based costing. Using this cost driver, we calculate the driver rate, which is more accurate than the overhead absorption rate. Before we discuss about the activity-based costing, there are a few terms you need to know about before we proceed. Activity. What is an activity? An activity refers to a specific task or process that consumes resources and adds value to a product or service. For examples, setting up machines, inspecting products, designing products, processing orders or handling consumer inquiries. All these are activities within an organization. These will be consume resources and add values to a product or service. Cost pool. A cost pool refers to a grouping of individual costs that are related to a specific activity or process. For an example, consider a company that produces cars. The company has identified three major activities that incur costs: purchasing raw materials and components, assembling the car, and shipping the finished products. All these are activities. The costs associated with purchasing raw materials and components, such as the cost of materials, shipping and storage, would be grouped together in a cost pool. Simply, a cost pool is a combination of individual costs which are specific to an activity or process. Cost object. A cost object is anything for which a cost is calculated, such as a product, service or department. For an example, consider a company that produces cars. The company has identified three major activities that incur costs: purchasing raw materials and components, assembling the car, and shipping the finished products. The cost object could be a specific type of car, which is a product, such as a sedan or the entire production process of all cars. It can be either a product, service, or anything that can be incurred costs. Cost driver. This is the most important term under activity-based costing. A cost driver is the factor that causes a cost to be incurred, such as the number of units produced, hours worked, or any factor which causes a cost to change. This is the same example as before. So, the cost driver for the raw material cost pool could be the number of units of raw materials purchased. The cost driver for the assembly cost pool could be the number of labor hours required to assemble each car. The cost driver for the shipping cost pool could be the distance traveled to deliver the car. Simply, a cost driver is a factor which causes a cost to change. There are three types of cost drivers. Transaction drivers. These are cost drivers that measure the number of transactions or activities that occur in a particular process. For an example, number of customer orders processed, the number of invoices generated, or the number of purchase orders issued. These are all transaction drivers. The second one is the duration drivers. These are cost drivers that measure the amount of time spent performing a particular activity or process. For examples, the number of hours spent on machine setup, the time spent on quality control, or the time spent on product design. All of these cost drivers are related to the duration. Intensity drivers. These are cost drivers that measure the amount of resources used or consumed during a particular activity or process. For example, the amount of raw materials used, the amount of energy consumed, or the number of miles driven for delivery. Now that we know all the terms under activity-based costing, now let's discuss about the different types of costs under activity-based costing. There are four types: unit level costs, batch level cost, product level costs, and facility level costs. The first type of cost, unit level costs. These are costs that are directly related to the production of a specific unit of a product or service. For examples, unit level costs include direct materials and direct labor costs. This is very easy to identify. These costs will be incurred at the unit level. So, all the direct costs can be identified as unit level costs. The second type of cost, batch level costs. These are the costs that are incurred each time a batch of products is produced or a service is performed. Now, let's get to know about what is a batch. In manufacturing and production processes, a batch refers to a specific quantity of products or materials that are processed, produced, or handled together in a single operation. The size of a batch can vary depending on the production process, the type of product being made, and other factors such as equipment capacity or material availability. These are the examples for batch level costs: machine setup costs, inspection costs, and testing costs. Product level costs. These are the costs that are associated with the particular product or service, regardless of how many units are produced or services provided. These are the examples for product level costs: product design costs, engineering costs, and advertising costs. These costs will be incurred at the product level. The final type of cost, facility level costs. These are the costs that are not directly related to the production of a specific product or service, but are necessary for the overall operation of the organization. These are the examples for facility level costs: rent, utilities, and administrative salaries. These costs will be incurred for the whole organization. Now let's discuss about the steps to follow in activity-based costing. There are 6 steps. In order to calculate the driver rate, you need to follow these steps one by one. First one is identification of major activities which incur costs. Second one is aggregation of activities. Third one is allocation costs to identified activities. Fourth one is identify cost drivers. The fifth one is measure cost drivers. This is known as the driver value. Driver value is equal to total of cost driver values for an activity. And finally, calculate cost for cost driver. This is known as the driver rate. This is similar to the OAR under absorption costing. And assign the overheads to the products based on the driver consumption. Now let's do an example so you can understand how to use the activity-based costing. Company A manufactures product 1 and product 2. Machine setup cost is budgeted to be $170,000 in the next year. Following are the budgeted values for the next year. Calculate the machine setup cost per unit for product A and product B using activity-based costing. So what is the first step? First step is to identify the major activities. There are only one activity, which is given here as the machine setup cost. Setting up the machine is the major activity here. If there are more than one activity, you need to identify the activities separately. The second step is to aggregate the activities. Since there is only one activity, we do not have to do the second step. Aggregation of activities means there can be activities which can be combined into one major activity. Then the third step is to allocate the costs to the identified activities. So they have given the cost for the activity, which is $170,000 for this activity. So this is the cost pool for machine setup cost. And the fourth step is to identify a cost driver. They have given here 3 cost drivers: total production units, batches of products, and labor hours per unit. Between these cost drivers, we have to identify an accurate cost driver, which will cause the machine setup cost to change. First of all, what we have to do is we have to identify this activity under the different types of costs we discussed under activity-based costing. Machine setup cost is a batch level cost. If you can remember, we discussed about unit level costs, batch level costs, production level costs, and facility level costs. So machine setup cost is a batch level cost. So using that insight, we can find an accurate cost driver. So they have given the batches of products, which means these are the number of batches for product A and product B. We can select this as the cost driver, because machine setup cost is a batch level cost and they have given the batches of products. So we select the batches of products as the cost driver. Now that we know the cost driver, we have to calculate the driver value. driver value is equal to the total of the cost driver values, which is this value and this value. So the driver value is 5 plus 12, which is equal to 17. The unit of this 17 is batches. So there are 17 batches. As the final step, what we have to do is we have to calculate the driver rate. This is similar to the OAR. If you can remember, we calculated the OAR by dividing the production overheads by the activity level. So here what we are going to do is we are going to divide the production overhead, which is the machine setup cost, which is $170,000, by the driver value. Driver value is 17. So this is equal to $10,000 per batch. This is the driver rate. If you can remember, this is similar to the OAR under absorption costing. And finally, what we have to do is we have to find the per unit value for product A and product B. Now let's find out the per unit value for product A. As you can see, they are budgeted to produce 1000 units of product A and 1200 of product B. And they have given the number of batches. For product A, there will be 5 batches. For product B, there will be 12 batches. Using these two figures, we can calculate the number of products for one batch. So we can simply divide the number of products by the number of batches, and then we can calculate the number of units per batch. So there will be 200 units per batch for product A. For product B, there will be 100 units per batch. So using these figures, we can calculate the machine setup cost per unit for both product A and product B. So for product A, the per batch cost is equal to 10,000 per batch. So there are 200 units per batch for product A. This will give us the per unit value, which is equal to $50 per unit. This is the final answer for product A. Now let's calculate for product B. So the per batch value is 10,000 per batch divided by the number of units per batch for product B, which is 100 units. So this is equal to $10 per unit. So these are the final answers. So for product A, the machine setup cost per unit is 50, whereas for product B, the machine cost per unit is $10. If we compare these values to the OAR value, you can identify there are two values. If we use the OAR method, there will be only one value, which is inaccurate. So now you have to realize that ABC is more accurate. Because for product A and product B, the machine setup cost per unit is different, which means these are more accurate than the OAR under absorption costing. I hope it is clear now. Now let's discuss about the advantages of activity-based costing. Accuracy. ABC provides a more accurate way to allocate costs to products, services, and customers based on the actual activities that consume resources rather than using arbitrary cost drivers. Cost control. ABC helps identify the actual costs of each activity, allowing organizations to identify and eliminate non-value-added activities, optimize their production processes, and reduce costs. Better decision making. ABC provides more detailed and accurate information on the costs of each product, service, or customer, which can help organizations make better decisions about pricing, product mix, and process improvements. ABC can be used for both manufacturing and service industries. Value adding and non-value adding activities can be easily identified. Now let's discuss about the disadvantages of ABC. Complexity. ABC can be complex and time-consuming process that requires significant resources to implement and maintain. There can be more than one cost driver for some activities. Not suitable for overheads, which are primarily driven by the production units, and for high direct costs incurring industries. Costly. Implementing ABC can be expensive, requiring investments in new technology, training and personnel. Limited applicability. ABC may not be suitable for all types of organizations or products, particularly for those with low volume or low complexity. Higher the types of products, higher the complexity. Limited data availability. ABC requires detailed information on activities, resources and cost drivers, which may not be available or easy to obtain. Resistance to change. ABC may face resistance from employees who are accustomed to traditional cost allocation methods and may not embrace the changes required by the new system. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.